seriously grew up thinking that it was impossible to have a medal at the Olympics. I thought it was impossible to win in a sport that has been so well known for doping in other countries in the world. So my goal was always to be as good as I could be. I wanted to prove the world that I can still be good without it.
There are cheats, there are athletes who doped, they were stripped from their medals.
The medal reallocation for that fair sport, for that clean sport.
This is focused on the athletes who haven't had that opportunity to celebrate.
Already.
Because we eat chocolate.
But why are we making a cake, kids?
Mama.
For mommy? Why?
Yeah, because it's your birthday.
You think it's my birthday? We will have a party, but it's not because mommy's getting older.
Yeah, people will come over to celebrate with us.
Weightlifting made the person I am now. From that little kid that was crying in the corner of her class because she was too shy to talk to people, I became double Olympic medalist, able to speak in front of thousands of people, express my story. So definitely weightlifting made me a lot more confident, and I guess it brought the best out of me. For now, I'm not training a lot because I'm pretty busy with my university course and my three young kids, but when I do get a chance, I can come in the basement and have my little moment. The basement of my new house that's obviously unfinished, but it's my little corner to be able to train and remind my body what it used to do before having three kids. Weightlifting was what made me the happiest. It's like time stop, but you know exactly what you have to do, and you go there and you just do your job. So the only thing I had to do was showing the world what I could do. I qualified for the Olympics in 2008 in May, and I competed in July. Competed at international level, I always asked my coach not to tell me the ranking. Knowing what ranking it would give me was just pressure I didn't need it.
Squeeze the bar. Big feet, big extension. Come on. Take your time.
When I finished my last attempt, when I came back, my coach told me that would have been bronze if you made it. I just missed it. And that destroyed me.
When we were in Beijing and Christine came fourth, we were so proud of her. She had an amazing competition. Fourth is nothing to be ashamed of or discouraged by within the Olympic community. What I think was a real challenge was when she came back to Canada and people kept saying, fourth, oh my God, that's the worst.
The feeling of failure was so intense. I actually had a depression following the 2008 Olympics. Between 2008 and 2012, what really kept me going, I would say, is that 3 kilos. That 3 kilos away from a podium is what helped me believe. Up overreaching and adding more than that to my total, and it's good because that's what I actually needed to be on the podium and get that bronze medal. In 2008, if I had the bronze medal, I would have been the first medal for my country and the only one for 3 days. That would have brought me so much attention from journalists. It would have brought so much attention to my sport. It would have empowered so many little girls that wants to do sport that are not really recognized for girls. It would have changed my life. Those 4 years were the hardest of my life. And when I learned that it should have been different, it was hard for me to take. It was hard. It's like I lived through a lie of some kind. I trained in a court that was barely heated. I ended up being my own coach because I had no other support. But it took me some time to make peace with that and to realize that actually those 4 years were the most transformative of my life. And I became who I am now because of that. A lot of people ask me if I'm upset at the woman that cheated, that were in front of me. And to be honest, I'm not, because I don't believe that it was their choice. I believe that it was their country's choice. So I'm upset at the people around them that made them or forced them to dope. And I feel like those athletes needs to be protected. My time. I was lucky enough to have a really long sport career. Now I'm ready for the next step, and for me the next step is coaching. What are you working on? I know the eyes is a better cue, but if you think about staying engaged in the neck, it might help keep that position stronger. Go.
Ah, you know it. Look at that face.
Elbows to shoulder height, and then you rotate and push.
That was nice.
I don't miss who I was. I'm just happy with what I have now. So we are getting back to my house. Pretty much all my family will be there, and we'll be happy to celebrate what's coming up tomorrow.
Hello. Hello.
Bonjour, ma belle chérie. Comment ça va? Madame Larico.
Weightlifting became our family passion. So everybody got involved. I have 3 sisters older than me. They all competed at some point.
Un toast à Christine pour sa médaille d'or à Londres et sa médaille de bronze à Pékin. Félicitations, Christine.
Bravo.
Merci.
Merci
à
tout le monde.
Merci. Ben, je vous remercie tout le monde d'être ici pour partager ça avec moi et célébrer. Ça fait des années que c'est pas juste moi qui travaille, mais vous autres aussi. Fait que je vous remercie beaucoup de m'endurer et de m'aider dans tout ce que je fais. Fait, à vous.
Merci.
Bon appétit.
Kilos des Jeux olympiques de Beijing 2008, Christine Girard.
There's a lot of people.
Mm-hmm. Representing Canada, winner of the bronze medal in the women's 63-kilogram weightlifting event at the Beijing 2008 Olympic Games, Christine Girard.
It's not just Canada, it's for all those around the world that believe in integrity and believe that sport without integrity isn't sport that we want to be part of.
At the end of the day, the reason we do sport is to be a part of community and to be connected to something and to pursue our passions. And I feel very fortunate to have had the chance to work with Christine. She leads by example. She's relentless in her efforts.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion in the women's 63-kilogram weightlifting event at the London 2012 Olympic Games.
so deserve it.
It's not just about me and my family anymore. It's not just our win. It's the win of our country and our values. And it's a win for clean sports. So all for those reasons, it's definitely worth the wait.